And we are underway here in game two of a home doubleheader this weekend for the Guildford Flames. A big win in the cup for them last night against the Blaze, which saw first in the league versus second in the league. And who would have predicted such a one-sided scoreline? Yes, Brovar's going to take that loose puck and score. Takes the water bottle, glove side on Berman. And what a wonderful start for the Storm. A turnover in. And the Flames should get this puck out the zone. They do through Fredericks. Here's Johnson. Johnson has Cole Carter heading to the net. Puck sent on the frame of the net of Berman. Might have come off the pad, excuse me. Good play here from Manchester. Chance out in front. Oh, a loose puck cranked from the point. There's a rebound. Berman scrambling. It's still there. It's still there, but the Guildford Flames have got their hands on it. And now here comes Ferguson with some gusto. Tries to take it around his man. He just sends it in front. It came off the defenseman under the pads of Levine. He was able to swipe that clear. So Connor stands his man up at the blue line. Here comes Tate. Oh, Tate has some speed. He's got around Harrison. He clangs one off the post. All action here in the spectrum. Oh, there's a loose puck in front for DeLuca. DeLuca takes around Berman. He hits the post. Oh, it was in the blue paint.
Get something on it and get that puck out of the zone. Here's DeLuca again.
Trying to find a route into the zone. DeLuca, nice hands. Great play from him. Fakes the shot. Pulls it in. Goes short side. Puck is still there to be had. It is in the hands of Fawcett. It's a good play from the Storm number 71. Chuck comes in from Critchlow on the half wall. Lalonde comes in to try and peel him off his man. There's a chance in front, they score. Cole Carter out in front. And the Manchester Storm have got a 2-goal lead. Riplinger showing some toughness to not only block the shot but carry it up ice. He finds Crinella. Crocock whips one from the point, he scores! Mike Crocock answers right back for the Flames. There's a whippy wrister.
Although they call them Ginner and Finner, when you've got a director in your ears and there's noise in the building, it'll be hard to discern the two. Anyway, it's a 2-on-1 with Lakovic. He's got some support on the right side. Oh, Lakovic, a great feed in front, and somehow that stays out. Riplinger.
Heart. Fancy a little bit of hands from the big man. He's able to bring this puck up ice. Drops it off. Oh, it's going to be a chance for Simmons. He shoots it. Saved by Berman. It's still end-to-end here in Surrey. Fancy hands again by McNulty. He brings it across the line. Chance comes in. They score. Kyle Lock roofs it. Oh, there's a loose puck right out in front of Levine.
Flames just couldn't get to it cleanly. They still have the puck down behind the goal line, though. McNulty cycles it. Clement fires one off the body in front of him. Oh, Ulrich out the box. He's going to get a breakaway.
Ulrich on Berman. Shoots, scores. Finley Ulrich right out the box. He gets his first of the season.
Had to do some quick maths then. Glad I could do that. As I put the stats up separately for both teams. Casey and Maine. Maine, a relatively new franchise in the East Coast. The loose puck out in front. They score!
A game-tying goal from Tate. And again, just a puck battle won on the boards.
Two very different leagues in terms of their makeup, the Norwegian league and the French league. Shot from the point. Redirected, they score!
A heavy tip in front. Something again from kind of nothing.
I remind you, he's a defenseman, but you know, Ryan Finty's coach ran all the power plays through Dallas Earhart. Here's Tedesco into the corner, walks along the goal line to the back door, they score!
The winner from Lalonde. And that's all she wrote to the close, hard fought game here in the Spectrum Leisure Centre. It went to OT, a power play decided it. We'll have a look at this one again. Guildford just using that space nicely, finding a passing lane as